Hi, you're watching VSDC channel. Today, we've prepared a short video hack. Many of you asked how to highlight objects in a video, and from this tutorial, you'll find out how to do just that. In one of the recent tutorials, we showed you how to place text behind an object, and the biggest challenge was to apply motion tracking when the object changed its perspective. The reason why it was so challenging was because we only had one tracking point. This time, we'll try to use four tracking points and see what happens. Create a new project and import your footage. In our case, it's a model. To properly highlight her face, we need just four tracking points placed at the top and right, the bottom, the left-hand sides. So, make a right mouse click on the video and select Create Movement Map. Place the tracking point at the forehead and hit Start Analysis. Once analysis is over, hit Apply Editing. Now, do the same for the right side, left side, and the chin, so that in the end, you get four movement maps. Duplicate the video and make a click on the object you want to place behind the head, in this case, for example. Next, select the Free Shape tool. To create a shape with a smooth border without corners, switch from linear path to spline path. Place the first point on the forehead, the second one on the right cheek, the third one on the chin, and the fourth one on the left cheek. We got a shape resembling an egg, but it actually works for our video. Now, open the first point, the one on the forehead, and switch to the Editor tab. Then open the Add Object menu and select Movement Map. Repeat the same steps for the remaining tracking points. Well, look at that! The shape changes along with the head's position. Now, paint the shape black and open the Blending Mode menu. Then select Mask, Inverted Mask. You can also apply the Gaussian Blur filter to blur the edge of the shape. If you wanted to apply the effect to the face, you'd need to place the effect layer near the shape inside of the video file or its duplicate. If you liked this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Until next time!